Soon the men and women of our Provincial Reconstruction Team will be leaving the Bamyan province, where for more than a decade New Zealand soldiers have done so much to help rebuild Afghanistan. It's been a big commitment by a small country. By the time they go, there will have been 21 PRT and 11 SAS rotations involving around 2,800 Defence Force personnel. There's also been some police and foreign affairs staff who have helped serve in Afghanistan. Afghanistan was, to all intents and purposes, a failed state when we first went in as part of a multinational intervention. Partly, our involvement's been humanitarian, focused on the development of Bamyan province. We've made some good gains there. I visited Bamyan a couple of years ago, and it's a vastly different place from what it was like before the New Zealand PRT deployed there. It's been transformed, and it's a place where kids now have a chance. Our other purpose was to help shore up the security of the province for the wider country. For too long, Afghanistan was the base for training and the support of extremists, some who have gone on to commit acts of international terrorism. So there was, if you like, a degree of self-interest for other countries to be involved. Knowing that you're standing up for what's right and just makes the job easier. Since 2001, Kiwi troops in Afghanistan have been defending the right of ordinary, often voiceless and powerless citizens to live free of fear and repression. In my book, that's being on the right side. Afghanistan is far from perfect, but it's come a long way towards stability in the time we, alongside other nations, have been involved. Recently, I announced that when the main contingent of our troops leaves Afghanistan soon, a small group of 27 in all will serve us for at least another 12 months, based mainly in Kabul. These Kiwis will be in roles that are vastly different. They will not have combat roles and will operate behind the wire. New Zealand-funded development programs in Bamyan and renewable energy, agriculture, education and health will also continue. The reason for this is that any job that's worth doing is worth doing properly. Most of the other nations who have been involved are also making a commitment to supporting the transition process. That'll give Afghanistan the best chance of building on what's already been achieved. I'm proud of our soldiers and other personnel who have served in Afghanistan, and also of their families, because we make a big ask of them too. The greatest sacrifice has been made by those who lost their lives. 10 of our soldiers have fallen while we've been in Afghanistan. I can tell you, there's no worse call to take as Prime Minister than receiving that news. But their sacrifice makes the way we finish the job all the more important. I know we're going to leave knowing that our share of the job's been done as well as it could have been.